I'm Dr. Ryan DeBell from The Movement Fix. This is Movement Fix Monday. What I want to talk to you about in this video is rethinking the purpose of the butt wink, which is the low back, which is thought to be the low back rounding in the bottom of a squat. But I think the low back rounding in the bottom of the squat is not what the butt wink truly is. And it's not the purpose of the butt wink. The purpose of the butt wink is not to round the low back. The purpose of the butt wink is to reorient the hip socket. It's to move where the hip is in space and time versus it just simply being rounding the back. So let me explain, because I'm sure that's going to be somewhat of a challenging statement in some cases. So consider this. When you squat, the motion should be primarily through the hip joint when we're doing high repetition or loaded squatting. We don't want the back to round. But if you get to a limitation for some reason, say you have a limitation in the extensibility of your adductor muscles, your groin muscles, or you have a limitation in your hip joint, that person may have to change where the hip is pointing in order to achieve more depth. So, say I put the hip at this range of motion, and for this athlete, that's as far as their hip joint can actually move. In order for them to gain greater depth, they have to point the socket of the hip up versus where it's currently pointing. So, since they can't do this more, what they do is they round their back to change the position of their pelvis, which changes where the hip joint itself is pointing. So the butt wink isn't just the low back rounding. The butt wink is the athlete using a strategy of moving the hip joint itself versus moving in the hip joint. Now the real question is, why the heck are they doing that? For some people, the hip joint just won't move more. For others, it could be that they don't know how to not move their hip joint. That would be more of a motor control issue. They don't know the technique of squatting. So what they do is they come down here, they get to a certain depth where they don't know how to move through this little bit of extra range, and so they, instead of moving in the hip, they round their back like this, which is really just so they can reorient their pelvis, and it allows them to get some depth. We just see that their back is rounding, so we go, oh, don't round your back. But they are, for some reason, developing the strategy to reorient the hip socket. Now, is that a bad thing? Is that a good thing? Well, it depends. If somebody's hip joint ends, the only way they can really get deeper is to round their back, or they're gonna have to get more ankle range of motion or wear a lifting shoe. But what's interesting is the same sort of thing is true in the shoulder. We reorient the socket of the shoulder joint all the time. That's the shoulder blade moving. So if you were looking at somebody from the back and this was their shoulder blade, and unfortunately for this model, I can't take the arm off, but if you could take this off, you would see the socket of the shoulder joint right here. When you raise your arm up overhead, this sort of swings around and you reorient the socket of the shoulder joint to point in the direction where your arm is moving so that you get combined motion of this as well as in the shoulder joint itself. However, the difference is in the shoulder, this isn't connected to the spine. It doesn't make your neck move because of how it's attached. So in the shoulder, it's actually a helpful thing to do because there's no spinal consequence to reorienting the shoulder joint. To reorient the hip joint, there is a spinal consequence because of how the pelvis is attached to the lumbar spine. And so when we think about the hip with the butt wink, I want to explore the idea that it's more than just rounding the back. It's the athlete repositioning themselves, and we have to figure out why. Do they not know how to do it? Is it a limitation in the hip joint? Is it a limitation in the extensibility of the musculature around the hip joint? Is it because they have long legs and that's their strategy to keep their mass over their base of support? Do they not have good ankle range? Those are the things that we have to think about. It's not just their back is rounding. It's much more in depth than that. So hopefully that is a thought-provoking idea for you guys. And that's what I wanted to share with you guys on this week for Movement Fix Monday. Make sure to check out all our videos on themovementfix.com/blog. You can also follow me on Facebook at facebook.com/themovementfix. And make sure to check us out on Instagram @themovementfix. I'll see you guys next week.